And we're now joined on the line by the widow of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel De Gamo, Pamplona Mayor Janice De Gamo. Mayor De Gamo, good morning to you, ma'am.
Yes, Ma'am Karen, good morning, and to all your listeners and people watching you po right now, good morning.
All right, before we get into the details, can you please give us your reaction with the ethics panel rejecting the request to expel Congressman Tevez?
Of course, I'm quite sad about it because our desire really was to have him expelled. But I think what was given to him was the two-month suspension. But then again, we are still hopeful that after the suspension and after looking for other avenues that we might bring again to the Ethics Committee of Congress, we will really be able to get the expulsion that we want for this congressman to get.
Okay, but Mayor De Gamo, I mean, who actually lodged the complaint? It's quite surprising that something as basic as the letter, actually they claim it lacked form and content, but more than that, it wasn't a sworn complaint. One would assume that your lawyer would know the requirements before filing an ethics complaint.
Actually, Congress was about to have a recess at that time, and I think there was some legal lapses because had we known that it has to be, how do you call that?
That it has to be had sworn known that complaint. Yeah.
That it will be, then okay. we could have it notarized. But then again, the affidavit being attached to the letter are all notarized. So maybe we were not able to see that part, that the letter that I have to be that I need to, what was the term again that you were using, Ma'am Karen?
Oh, that it has to be a sworn complaint.
Yeah. That we could have done that, but I can also understand that the session was about to take a break, you know, and along that line, perhaps we mislooked that part. So
okay, now but then, Mayor De Gamo,
here after we get to know what will be the next step of the of Congress, we might explore another avenue to have him expelled, like the angle on gambling that can also be something that we might also explore to get the expulsion.
But all right, but then the congressman said there's a possibility he could be expelled because his leave would lapse on May 22, and not only that he actually applied for asylum to another country. So that may be a stronger argument for expulsion. Would you agree?
I think so too. I am no lawyer, but I think the reason why Congressman Arnie wouldn't confirm nor deny whether or not he seek asylum in another country was because for fear that it might really be the reason that he will be expelled. So I will be very happy if Congress will pursue that. And not just me, along with me are hundreds and maybe thousands others from Negros Oriental who would love to see him expelled from work.
Okay. Now, it was an anticipated flight, as the report said. Many were thinking that Arnulfo Tevez Jr. would be on that flight back home. Did you actually think he was going home?
You know, ma'am, even if DOJ said that, SOJ rather, said that it came from a reliable source, but in my heart, I could feel he really wouldn't want to go home. So no doubt at all on my part that this man will not come home on his own free will. There has to be a search warrant, and maybe countries, no, wherever he will be, will take him back to the Philippines.
Okay, now are you satisfied, Mayor De Gamo, with how the case is going, frankly speaking. I mean, it's already 2 months. There's still no warrant of arrest against Arnulfo Teves. He's still out of the country. The NBI only filed murder charges. I think it was just the other day. So are you satisfied?
Our wait was quite long, and I would believe that because it was a long wait, it was a well-polished and a solid case. That is as far as I know. While there were things being said about some of the witnesses, you know, binabawi nila what they said first, I was also oriented by my private lawyers because I have a private counterpart to our government prosecutors who oriented me that cases, no, criminal cases like this usually would go through a particular stage where you can expect of the witnesses will take back their words. And but then again, I was also assured that what we have on hand, what I know of what we have in terms of evidence, we will still be able to win this case.
Okay. Attorney Baligod says two of the household staff or inner circle home staff, I'm not sure if it's the help in the home, but two of the inner circle of your husband were actually informants of the bodyguard.
Yeah.
Have you determined that to be true?
I was also about that, and I think that was true. We were asked to, to submit or to take pictures of people who are around the house, and we tried to confirm and make the connection. Some of these people are connected and to the death of the governor. And I think Attorney Baligod has a point in saying that. That's
okay.
True. Okay.
All right. Mayor Degamo, anything else you'd like to add before we go?
I think I just would like to point out a report being said by Senator Bato de la Rosa. He kept on telling everyone that they cannot come up with a report at the moment because the two parties are parang may nakikita na negative. May mga nakikita parang pinapaniwalaan niya yung sinasabi nila na warlords ang mga Digamo at yung mga Teves. I think I just would like to react to that, but that was a media spin from the other camp because, Ma'am Karen, buhay pa yung asawa ko when I requested from Senator De La Rosa na gawin nila yung Senate investigation dahil nababahala kami pag may pinapatay at pinapangalan nila ang husband ko na nagpapapatay. Blessing in disguise po at nang mangyari yung kay Sandy Tinguha at kay Jason Ong, buhay sila, they themselves discovered that it was not Digamo after all. It was the Teves na talagang nag-ano sa kanila na ipapatay sila. So there are things like this, yung mga Melodia cases. I also interested even Yusek Eggo about the Cornelio case. Pero parang kasi pinasali ni Senator De La Rosa yung mga Barkers. Ray Lapping, Jerome Nalam, Marlon Bato. Kahit yung si Kitty na parang tingin ko stage yung pagkakabarin kaniyang fence ng bahay niya just so she could come to the Senate, eh talagang sa tingin ko something went wrong there. Dapat kasi victims yung pinapasalita doon eh. At so that he will be able to get to the bottom of things. But then parang nagkanda mali-mali yung Senate investigation because lahat ng accusation not related to killings, parang nagiging market na tayo eh. And that was not our intention in coming to the Senate. Kaya I would like to make the correction and I would really tell everyone listening to you, Ma'am Karen, that hindi po kami warlords at hindi po kami mamamatay tao, lalong-lalo na pong hindi kami nang agrabyado ng lupa, nang aagaw ng lupa, at hindi po kami nang aagaw ng negosyo. That's why we went to the Senate because we want government to know what's happening to Negros and they can conduct investigation and prevent things from really going out of control. Dahil pag hindi po ito nahinto, ay talagang walang mangyayari sa amin dito kung hindi yuyuko at yuyuko ka na lang to powers na mapang-abuso. Kaya nagusto ko lang mag-react because that is the report Senator Bato keeps on telling the public na parang ginagawa nilang pareho kami ng mga Teves. No, I agree with that. That's true.
My last question is actually, you made a good point that the Senate hearing is already expanding to other issues and it's not centering already on the investigation on the killing. Does this actually help your case and finding justice for your husband that it's already expanded to so many other issues about the province?
Not that it would affect the case, but it may defeat some purpose. Although, honestly, may na-achieve din tayo doon. There are small victories, katulad ng now the name Alfonso Tan of the Alabata case have been given the necessary correction and the appropriate person will be facing charges in court. So hindi na yung make-up fictitious na yung binibigay. Yung mga inabuse ng lupa, talagang they are being entertained and catered by DAR and DENR. Parang may na-achieve din. However, what I find parang hindi naman po tama, when they include things like si Governor Digamo, certified diagnosed maniac, mga ganun po na pananalita na this has nothing to do with the governor. This has nothing to do with the death of the governor and the death of so many others. But you patronize.
But then that's what happens. That's also
yes,
what happens.
In other words, it's more than that. Masaklap doon, the governor is no longer around to defend himself. Kaya masabi ko, bakit naman i-entertain yung hindi victim? Ang ini-entertain, Barker, mga nagsasalita yun ng election, everything that they have said about the governor, they said it already. Time and again in all the three elections that the governor went through.
So I guess essentially what you're asking for is focus in the Senate hearings. Is that fair?
Yes. Well, nawawala yung focus. But I will understand very well, Ma'am Karen, if everyone being interviewed there are victims. Kahit pa sabihin na lang natin na perpetrated by governor na kinakasuhan nila o pinupoint nila. Okay na rin yun eh, kasi para ma-discuss din thoroughly. But, you know, to entertain these people saying that the governor is like this and like that, and every intriga na classmate niya si governor, siya gumagawa ng assignment ni governor, that it did not happen at all. Wala pong diploma yun sa Siliman at hindi sila magkaklase nung Ray Lapin.
Okay.
You're right, nawawala sa focus.
Kaya, I think it's about focus din tayo and moderating. Yeah, so it's really an issue about focus and facilitating the Senate hearings. Okay, well, I want to thank you, Mayor Janice Degamo, for joining me today. You take care, ma'am, and hope to speak with you again soon.
Thank you po, Ma'am Karen, and thank you sa lahat ng opportunity na marinig kami. Salamat po.